The long-awaited arrival of Yoimiya is finally over, and this video showcases her builds and team compositions at Zero Constellations. Yoimiya is definitely one of those cases where you have to focus on what she's got to offer, which are going to be her normal attacks that specialize in dealing single target damage from a safe distance. Positioning is key with her, but as always, it will depend on what kind of teammates you have. Speaking of which, she's been extensively tested with several team compositions, which later on get showcased in the video, and her artifacts as well as weapons play a big part when trying to decide how you want to build her and play her. Now, the thing about her elemental skill is that while it gets infused with pyro elements, the damage you deal will increase gradually because of the passive skill, which gives 2% extra pyro damage bonus up to 10 times, for a total of 20%, while the stacks always refresh on the next hit, and because her damage rotation revolves around unloading all those normal attacks through the whole duration, it will naturally build up unless you get interrupted for longer than 3 seconds, which is why it's important to always keep a distance between your enemies. Also, the second passive she has boosts your other teammates' attack when using her burst, not to mention the bonus becomes bigger, depending on how many stacks you had built up from the first passive mentioned. So, if your rotation involves using her skill first, then the burst, always remember the attack bonus will be higher with the stacks you've built up. Finally, regarding the beautiful burst itself, after the initial explosion, she will leave a mark on one of the enemies, and what's great about it is the pretty huge transfer range. So, when your currently affected target gets defeated, it will most likely jump onto someone else, even if they are quite far away. This also means if you suddenly switch her out, the fireworks mark will remain on the battlefield, so you can use other teammates to finish the enemy, who will also hopefully have the attack boost gained from the second passive. Overall, there are some interesting caveats to her playstyle that you can definitely play around with, but it does require you to understand some of the more intricate things like internal cooldown, which is a hidden mechanic miHoYo developed to give a limit to the amount of elemental reactions you can cause within a certain time. So this means you have to examine the way she is built and what teammates she uses in order to take full advantage of her normal attacks. And as always, if you appreciate her design, then that's what matters the most, and we're here to see what's the best way to build this fireworks business owner. Building Yoimiya is all about embracing her playstyle, which also means there's going to be a couple of choices depending on what type of player you are. First of all, when it comes to weapons, hands down the best 4-star weapon is going to be Rust, if you can manage to build up a good enough critical rate and damage ratio, so you can consistently score massive critical hits with the insane passive the weapon provides. In fact, at max refinement, Rust can even outperform Amo's Bow and Skyward Harp at first refinement, but keep in mind, the builds for this testing have been fine-tuned with very good critical rate and damage. Speaking of which, it seems to be that miHoYo is continuing the trend of releasing new 5-star weapons that are the perfect fit for the new 5-star characters, and Thundering Pulse is no exception to this. You'll definitely feel a damage difference it can provide compared to any other weapon, since the passive and even the substat are quite hyper-focused to help Yoimiya fully unleash her potential with normal attacks, so this is basically the best in slot bow you can equip her with. As for the remaining alternatives, besides Rust and Thundering Pulse, you can slap on her Blacklift Bow for the substat, even if it means having a pretty unreliable passive, but for those who just want the simple, free-to-play solution, you can always go for Prototype Crescent, especially if you have no trouble hitting enemy weak points, because that attack bonus is pretty huge, and the bow overall is quite decent on her. And if you're wondering about the new Inazuma Bow, well, it's great, but the passive is demanding, since you need to maintain full energy, and it complicates matters even more if you're using it together with the new Reminiscence artifact set. Finally, as previously mentioned, unrefined Amo's Bow and Skyward Harp remain as top choices beneath Thundering Pulse and Max Refined Rust. But that's just her weapons recommendations. Looking at the artifacts, the safest possible choice you can make for her build, without needing to worry about any special circumstances, would be a double 2 set of Crimson Witch, and one of the other ones that provides additional 18% attack. Just understand the emphasis on the word safe, because you won't need to do anything different with your damage rotation, and you'll get very good performance out of these said bonuses. However, if you're ready to make some changes to Yoimiya's playstyle, the newest 4-piece Reminiscence artifact set is looking for an owner willing to adapt and reap the rewards. Now, this mainly has to do with how the bonus works. Anytime you use elemental skill, if you have more than 15 energy, you lose 15 energy and gain a whopping 50% damage increase to your normal charge and plunge attacks. But here's the tricky part. If you, let's say you use Yoimiya's burst as an opener, then it's only advised to follow up with her elemental skill when you have more than 15 energy, and gaining it can get tricky if you're not using something like Electro Traveler's amulets. Otherwise, you need to keep a close eye on incoming elemental particles and land the burst at the right moment to immediately charge up energy. What this also means is that if your team lacks the proper energy generation, this set will also be problematic to keep the tempo up because Yoimiya herself doesn't generate particles that well. But then your next question is, what's stopping her from using her elemental skill first, then burst? And the answer is, nothing. It's just that you also need to quickly gain back the energy for the burst so you can unleash it and double down with her infused pyro attacks. Overall, this set could be categorized as high risk, high reward, and it's actually pretty satisfying to implement in Yoimiya's playstyle. You just have to understand the consequences of doing so. Finally, the remaining artifact choices could be either a full set of Crimson Witch. If you're mainly going to use her with vaporized team comps, just keep in mind she won't trigger reactions all the time because of internal cooldown. But then there's 4-piece retracing Belied for that ultra specific build if you have Zhongli in your team. And finally, Lava Walker's full set if you're going to use her in a mono pyro team, which will get showcased in just a moment. Now for the stats, it's gonna be more simple. Just build her like any other damage dealer and focus on getting those critical rate and damage substats, while anything else like attack percentage and elemental mastery are good to have as second priority stats. And as for the talent priority, besides getting everything to level 6, you should then focus on maxing out normal attacks and then follow up with burst, which scales better than the elemental skill because of initial damage and explosions it will cause. But that's basically it. You've got several artifact choices to go for, one that's less demanding and other asking you to play by their rules, while weapons themselves pretty much are self-explanatory and really depends on just how lucky you are with the gacha system. Either way, it's not just the equipment that makes the character, but the team itself. When it comes to team building, it's clear that Yoimiya excels with her normal attacks, so finding the right friends to help her out and creating a reliable damage output is the thing we're looking for. Now keep in mind, because her charged attack essentially acts as a flavorful display of her fireworks instead of delivering serious damage, the onslaught of normal attacks infused with pyro will be the most often way to trigger a good number of elemental reactions. But because of the internal cooldown, she won't trigger a reaction from each attack. But with this out of the way, a team you'll probably see getting used with her quite often is surprisingly going to be centered around Electro, and the duo partner that helps capitalize on Yoimiya's normal attacks is going to be none other than Captain Beto, while the remaining teammates would be either Fischl or the new Electro Traveler to act as your battery and relieve the firework business owner from the energy generation headaches. But for the last spot, it's kind of flexible, with obvious choices being like Benny Boy, Venti, Kazuha, or basically anyone who can supply with good healing and buffs or crowd control. Now, this team especially shines if Beto has her second constellation unlocked and helps address the issue with Yoimiya's centric focus of single target damage. So getting those additional burst attacks to jump between enemies is pretty invaluable to achieve some decent AoE damage. Also, make sure to consider the trade-offs when choosing between Fischl or Electro Traveler, because the former gives you better damage output, while the latter supplies you with more energy. So if Yoimiya struggles with consistent burst application, it might be a better idea to go with Electro Traveler instead, even if their offensive capabilities aren't that great, unless you decide to build some elemental mastery on top to produce those big overload hits from the Traveler's burst. Oh, and if you're wondering, the Traveler is going to be the one who will trigger elemental reactions when the burst is active on Yoimiya, and it's all thanks to its delayed animation. The next team that works together with Yoimiya's normal attacks would be a mono pyro, or in some cases duo pyro resonance compositions. And the basic idea is that since there's some limitations with her trying to trigger elemental reactions, why not just skip that part and go straight to raw pyro damage instead? And to help you achieve this, going for a good animal support like Kazuha or Venti, as well as Sucrose that has a full set of Viridescent to shred enemies' resistance, is the first step to exploiting this one element. But then you obviously want to have Benny Boy and Xiangling for quick and easy damage rotation. The other alternative would be Zhongli and either Albedo or Ningguang for double pyro and geo resonance, as well as having a full set of Archaic Petra on one of the geo teammates. Finally, let's not forget that we've still got vaporized variations, even though they aren't going to be fully utilized because of the internal cooldown Yoimiya's attacks have to deal with. And of course, you know it's inevitable not to have Xing Qiu in your Vaporize team, so him and preferably Benny Boy, along with Sucrose to boost team's elemental mastery and damage, is the best way to squeeze out those big vape attacks. But if everything else fails, just dump Fischl, Xing Qiu and Bennett into the team and go for an easy to pilot composition, which is laser focused on single target damage, without caring how many times you actually trigger the reactions because of raw power it offers. On a first look, Yoimiya doesn't seem that complex, but after going through all the build and team options available, it's clear there isn't just one cookie cutter approach of how you can fully utilize her, not to mention how different she might feel once even more characters roll out in future updates. But it's easy to forget we're talking about a pyro character here, which is the element that has the most support given from miHoYo in the game's entire lifetime, even if recently the focus has shifted from amplifying reactions towards more different ways you can achieve competent damage. Overall, Yoimiya excels at single target performance, especially if you pair her with the right teammates like Beto, who can even help out with larger groups of enemies if you have few constellations unlocked on the pirate, but even then, the speed of the attacks that are dished out are pretty amazing with all things considered. The other big thing is safety, since she is a ranged damage dealer, which means having more time to react to enemies' incoming attacks, as well as retreating faster from close encounters, while at the same time keeping up the onslaught of normal attacks, targeting the enemy who is chasing you. However, one problem that arises from this particular playstyle is miHoYo's annoying implementation of auto-targeting, which sometimes can work against you when facing multiple enemies, and it's harder to aim the attacks than it is to compare to swinging any of the melee weapons. It also doesn't help that her best artifact set is directly working against her playstyle, forcing you to jump hoops with the way energy gets generated just in order to get that extra 50% damage for normal attacks. And speaking of limitations, the internal cooldowns set on her normal attacks and bursts are pretty severe, making it hard to score consistent elemental reactions, which puts a damper on team compositions. Still, even with everything said and done, she's really good at what she does, which is acting as your ranged sniper from a distance, and since you don't need to use aimed attacks unless you have the free-to-play bow, the speed at which you'll be able to take care of an enemy facing you is going to be satisfying to say the least. Hope you enjoyed this review and build of Yoimiya. Making these types of videos takes a ton of time and resources, so you'd really help out if you could subscribe to the channel and gently press the like button. Thanks for watching and see you soon.